A former high-ranking officer with the West Memphis Police Department won't do any jail time after admitting he sexually assaulted an underage girl. Billy Ray Sanders' no-contest plea in an Arkansas court this morning also means he avoids a trial. Tonight, his attorney says there's a twist to the story. Fox 13's Celie Devereaux spoke with his attorney and an officer of his former police department. She joins us now with more. Celie?
Merle, Sanders appeared in Mississippi County Circuit Court after petitioning for a change of venue out of Crittenden County early on in this case. However, after nearly 2 years, his decision not to fight the charges and plea was granted.
There's now some resolution for all the parties, and people can move forward with their lives.
By pleading no contest to a negotiated plea deal, former West Memphis Police Inspector Billy Ray Sanders will avoid a jury trial and jail time. After pleading no contest to misdemeanor charges of sexual assault in the fourth degree and knowingly furnishing alcohol to a minor Tuesday morning before a judge in Mississippi County, Arkansas, he was sentenced to nearly a year in jail on both counts. But his sentence was suspended, so Sanders won't actually serve any time.
No official statement other than the Arkansas State Police handled the investigation. And we assisted them when they requested assistance.
Sanders was accused of giving alcohol to an underage girl and touching her through her clothing. His attorney, Bill Stanley, says although he maintained he didn't do it, Sanders didn't want to risk a bad outcome at trial.
At the time he left and retired from us, he was third in command with the police department, just below the assistant chief of police.
Sanders worked for the West Memphis Police Department for 18 years. The department says Sanders had already put in retirement papers due to medical reasons when in September 2008, the chief received a complaint alleging he was involved in inappropriate conduct with two minor females. Sanders' attorney says his eventual no-contest plea involved only one case and says Sanders also based the decision on serious health issues due to diabetes.
He always portrayed himself to be professional and it worked pretty well with the others here in the department.
Court officials say Sanders' plea does not require he register as a sex offender. What do you think about the verdict in this case? Let us know by sounding off at myfoxmemphis.com. In the studio, Celie Devereaux, Fox 13 News.
I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land.
We're going to begin with breaking news.
This is an historic moment. Right here in the United States, Barack
Obama
has been elected the 44th president
of the United States
of America.
He is going to set all of the wrongs of the past right.
Oakland has more than its share of problems, so Phil Matier asked, what should
President Obama's top priority be right now?
There is a long history in this country of African Americans and Latinos being stopped by law enforcement disproportionately. And that's just a fact.
Our top story is a heated racial controversy out of
Oakland, California,
which is now getting national attention because President Obama has weighed in.
Gun shots overnight in Oakland, and one of those doing the shooting was a police officer.
A police shooting in Oakland is sparking outrage.
An Oakland police officer shoots and kills a man following a traffic stop.
Deadly officer-involved shooting overnight in Oakland.
Police are defending the shooting death
that ended in gunfire.
Police said the officer involved was defending himself against a man with a gun.
The driver did not have a weapon.
This is the second deadly police officer-involved shooting in Oakland this week.
Tonight, Oakland police are defending their fourth officer-involved shooting in 2 weeks.
So this is the fifth officer-involved shooting just the past month, the ninth for the city of Oakland all of this year.
We are getting an inside look tonight at what is driving Oakland's skyrocketing murder rate.
From witness and police accounts, this is what we've pieced together.
Oakland's gang units have carved up an 11-square-mile region known as the Flatlands. This is the battleground in the ongoing war. And as the year comes to a close, the violence shows no signs of stopping.
Racial violence in Oakland, that is the subject of this evening's Talking Points memo after a New Year's Eve fight on a train. A transit officer in Oakland shot a young man dead, and as he lay on the ground, reportedly incapacitated.
Look at this shit. We don't give a fuck. Hey, and the police, man, fuck you.
The shooting has led to violent demonstrations.
With Oakland police playing a cat and mouse game with the pockets of protesters zigzagging through downtown Oakland. This all started when a group of about 100 marchers smashed a police car in the intersection and tried to turn it over. That's when the riot gear came out and the protesters began setting cars on fire out there. We counted at least 5 cars on fire out there. It got so bad.
I got hit by a beanbag.
To live my life as an outlaw all along. Remain strong in this planet full of player haters. They conversate with death row full of demonstrators. And in the end, drinking Hennessy made all my enemies envy me. So cold when I flow, eliminating easily. Fall to their knees, they plead for their right to bleed. While begging me to keep the peace. What I can see, closer to achieve. In times of danger, don't freeze. Time to be a G. Follow my lead, I supply everything you need. And out to game and the training to make a G.
Do you know why I pulled you over?
No.
Step out of the car now.
No.
One out of 30. One out of 30. 940B. Officer down. 74 on the block of MacArthur.
This is a citywide 940B. I need any available sergeant to respond and assist.
I need units to fan out. Spread out and look for these people.
It appears to be the greatest loss of life in the history of Bay Area law enforcement.
The tactical team is going to be going in, checking in the address, 2755 74th Avenue. I'd like radio silence. Sergeant Gonzalez will be leading the team.
Oh, fuck! Officer down, officer down.
940B.
We have one officer down. We have a suspect down. I can code 3 at the front door, copy?
3 police officers and a suspect are dead, and one officer is in grave condition following the pair of Saturday shootouts in Oakland, California.
With 4 officers killed in a single incident, the police death toll on this day is one of the highest ever in America.
An alert going out to all Oakland police officers. Be careful, especially before getting into your car.
The police believe that snipers have them in their sights in one Oakland neighborhood.
Someone in the crowd shot at police 7 times.
A suitcase-sized package was placed beneath an Oakland PD crime tech vehicle this morning.
The incident has threatened to raise tensions between the police and the Oakland community.
We're going to begin with breaking news. Oakland police involved in a standoff right now with a person they believe is armed. Playing out now at 74th and MacArthur in a building very familiar to Oakland cops.
On March 21st, 4 officers lost their lives by a gunman holed up in an apartment building. Well, it seems that another gunman has also holed himself up in that same apartment.
A new documentary depicts Oakland as a city held hostage by 10,000 gang members. If the claim of 10,000 gang members is true, that would mean that 2-3% of Oakland residents are in gangs. Oakland police say those numbers are inaccurate. The federal report suggests there may be 10,000 gang members in all of Alameda County, not just in Oakland.
This is sad, man. And this is why Oakland needs to get militant, man. This right here, this is the reason why Oakland needs to get militant, man, for real.